here we go back into it now. The Dow down about 80 points yesterday, but it's still sitting at 32.6, 32.7. You know, not too bad. The NASDAQ at 10,890 and the S&P 500 at 3,800. The point being is that we've had a lot of bouncing going on. It's gone down, it's come up, it's gone down, it's come up. I don't know where we're headed. I don't know if anybody knows for sure, but my next guest should have a better idea than me. Nick Hopwood is a certified financial planner, founder of and president of Peak Wealth Management. Nick, good to have you back. Good to see you.
Thank you, Steve. Good to be here.
You know, I don't know what to make of the market. You know, I try to make my best guess and have a strategy. I'm not sure it works. Sometimes it's just best to tighten your seatbelt and hang on. But Fed rates are going to go up again, I believe. Now I'm told that the rates could go to 5%, which is going to be really brutal on mortgages and car loans and interest rates on credit cards, all of those things, right?
That's absolutely right. So right now the Fed funds rate is 3%, and they're meeting today, and they're probably going to increase by 0.75% just today. And so it's going to ripple through the economy pretty quickly.
Yeah, worst case scenario.
Slow things down.
Yeah, worst case scenario, we were told, you know, 3 or 4 months ago, of course, we were told that inflation was transitory, too, by the government. But 3 or 4 months ago, we were told, you know, it'll max out at about 4% sometime in early to mid-2023. Well, if they go up 0.75 today, that puts us at 3.75 today, which means we're going to blow past 4% on our way to 5% long before we get to 2023. Isn't that what I'm looking at?
Yeah, what you're referring to is what people call the terminal rate. Where do they stop raising? And what will be interesting today is what Powell says after, during the press conference. Are they going to keep hammering us with these 0.75% increases, or will he reference a slowdown, a pivot, if you will, where maybe next time it would be a little bit less, only 0.5, and perhaps into January 0.25? The market is desperately looking for that language coming from Chairman Powell.
Yeah. So what do you think? What's the impact going to be here? Because, look, the big concern for people that are in retirement or close to retirement is that, you know, Joe Biden's already gobbled up a good portion of their savings through inflation. I mean, their purchasing power, if they had $1 million, it's now worth, you know, 10%. 15%, 20% less, depending on what they're buying. So in effect, he has gobbled up their retirement. The nest egg is being destroyed by these parasites called inflation, right?
Yeah, not only that, we have a portfolio that's down 20% on top of the 8% inflation. So that's a compounding mess right there.
There's some good news. See, Nick, you had to just go and cheer us up this morning. I appreciate that.
I do have some good news. There is a silver lining, Steve.
Well, let's have
right with the Fed funds rate at 3% today. That means your money markets are earning 3% now as well. And if you have a CD that goes out 6, 9, 12 months, you're looking at over 4%. I just had a client who had $1 million in the bank, of course, 4 different banks with the FDIC, and he's making 0.05. And now we're putting him into money markets and CDs. He's able to make $109 a day on his $1 million bank account, which is 4%.
But my question on that would be, if the inflation rate's 8% and the return is 4%, aren't you running 4 points behind? I mean, it's better than getting, you know, 20 points behind, but you're still running behind, aren't you?
You are. It's true. But at least, you know, at least the portfolio is not going down. At least he has access to it. So the Fed's challenge is exactly what you said, right? Their rates are at 3%, soon to be 3.75, but inflation is running at more than double. And so, you know, you're always losing ground against that inflation. The Fed desperately wants to slow that down. In order to do so, they need to raise rates and slow the economy down as well.
Right, but here comes the problem with that, Nick, and that is, and they've said this, and you've heard this, of course, as well, it'll mean people lose their jobs. In order to slow the economy down to where they want it for that target rate of about 2% inflation, it's going to trigger a hard recession. There is no soft landing anymore, is there?
It's tough to navigate a soft landing with inflation running so hot. and with them raising rates so aggressively. This is historic. It's historic inflation, and it's a historic policy response by the Fed. But let's not forget that we're just trying to dig ourselves out of the policy mess from the last 2 years.
No, that's a fair point you make. And I guess, you know, look, a crisis like this for the savvy investor could well mean opportunity. Could well mean opportunity because you can find companies that are undervalued. You can find places where you can plug in. And maybe it's, you know, one of these treasury bonds or something. Wherever you want to go where you can feel safe, that's one thing. But if you want to feel aggressive, there are real opportunities out there in a market like this, aren't there?
There are. With the market down 20%, traditionally that's been a nice entry point for the next couple of years, leading into a rebound. But also, we can actually not take so much risk and have nice expected returns over the next couple of years with fixed income. It doesn't have to be money markets and CDs. When we look at corporate fixed income over the next 8 to 10 years, with the yields that they're paying now, you can have a nice return without having to take so much equity risk.
There you go. Nick Hopwood, greatly appreciate you being here as always. He is the founder and president of Peak Wealth Management. Nick, greatly appreciate your insights. And if that doesn't work out, there's always the lottery worth $1.2 billion.
Good luck with that.
Yeah, good luck with that. Yeah. Thank you, sir, as always. Greatly appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
There you have it, yeah. I don't buy lottery tickets, to be honest, but I will today. Whatever it makes it to $1 billion, I figure, you know, what's a buck or $2 or whatever, you know? I'll scrape that out of the change in the bottom of the truck, right? And I'll dig that out of the floor. And by the way, anybody wins $1.2 billion, we can be besties, all right? We can be best friends, all right? You and I. We'll pal around together. Yeah, besties. I'll be back.